Hey guys, today I want to tell you about Skullduggery Pleasant by Derek Landy. Before I want to tell you about the book, let's look a little bit closer at the book. Because looking at the cover, I really like the design. And I also like the attention that they put into the design. Even in the back looks really nice as well. And when you open the book, in the front you have Stephanie and Skullduggery, the two main characters. And in the back you have Ghastly Bespoke and Tennis Lowe, their two associates. Also, I like the attention they put to the chapters. The first letter in each chapter is also a picture. I really appreciate the attention that was put into the design of the book because it makes reading the book a little bit more fun. And it is a fun read. Skullduggery Pleasant is a children's adventure with a mystery detective. The book tells the story of mystery detective Skullduggery Pleasant, and in this book he tries to solve the murder of Gordon Edgley, who's Stephanie Edgley's uncle. And Skullduggery meets Stephanie at the funeral, then when she inherits Gordon's house, and basically he saves her life when someone tries to break into her new house and steal a key from her, but she doesn't know what key. For Stephanie, this is a really big adventure. She's 12 years old when she inherits the fortune of her uncle, and she doesn't know that there is a magic world out there. So when Skullduggery comes in and saves her from this weird person that tries to steal a key from her, she's really, sort of scared and impressed at the same time. She's intrigued by this skeleton character who can snap his fingers and create a fire. And she wants to help solve the mystery. So that's basically what the story is about. Stephanie and Skullduggery solving the mystery of Gordon's death. And while they're doing that, they discover a really devious plan of a really great villain, Serpine. I don't really know how to say that. So that's the main plot, solving the mystery and fighting the bad guy. It's really nice. What I really liked about this book is how the magic world is introduced. Stephanie finds out a lot of things that are in this world that she hasn't been aware of, like magicians and sorcerers and the magic war and all these things and the history and of course her skeleton partner. Speaking of Skullduggery, he's a really pleasant character. Despite him being a skeleton and he should be scary and he should be mean because he's dead, he's rather funny and I like to read about his comments and when he talked about things that were really serious, but he didn't take them too serious because he doesn't take himself that serious. I really like that. Just as well as Stephanie, she's a really interesting character. In the beginning, I had trouble believing that she's just 12 years old. I had the feeling that she sounded more like 13, 14, 15. But by the time I got used to it, and I liked how she's really plunging herself into the adventure and how she's dealing with it. Also, I like the villain. Serpine is a really good villain. He has this really rad hand that he just points at people and can kill them with that. I think that's a good attribute for a villain. Another thing I really liked about the book is that it wasn't really predictable. A lot of things happened that really surprised me and I was like, oh, I didn't expect that. And I really like that. Also the magic things, the magic tricks and everything that they can use, that were interesting as well. And I think really well done. Overall, I have to say, I really liked the book. It was a fun adventure read. It wasn't too serious. It wasn't too dark. It's really nice and well done. I'm looking forward to read more about their adventures. Thank you all for watching and let me know if you've read the book. Bye bye.